Hi everyone, and welcome to PyReady's experience sharing sessions. I hope you had a great time till now and attending various experience sharing sessions. So this is something which is going to be, I think, really impactful and very different, and a lot of you will actually relate to it. So we have Neha Bagaria, who is the founder and CEO of Jobs for Her, and she will be talking about why we need more women in tech and what are her experiences and her career journey of, you know, rejoining workforce after having a career break. So Neha, over to you, and with that, I think you can get started.
Great, thanks. Hi everyone, it's a pleasure to be here. I'm just going to share my screen and run you all through a presentation. Whatever questions you'll have, do keep posting it in the chat session so that we can take some of these questions at the end of the session. All right. Okay, hope you all can see my screen. Niharika, could you give me a quick yes?
Yes, Neha, yes.
All right, perfect. Okay, so to start with, I would like all of you to think of the name of a successful CEO of a tech company. Now, there are studies that show that the majority of us would have imagined a male CEO like you are seeing here, you know, like Sundar Pichai, Steve Jobs, Mark Zuckerberg. And, you know, you're not alone. Even Google seems to think that the CEO of a tech company must be male. Very few of us would have thought of Ginni Rometty from IBM. So, if you search for a nurse, most of the search results will show you a female. And if you search for a computer engineer, you guessed it, it'll be male. In fact, a few years ago, Google tested an email feature which was designed to predict what someone wants to write. You know, a feature I'm sure many of us have also used frequently, and many of you might be working on how to build as well. Now, it turns out that Google's algorithms were making biased assumptions, referring, for instance, to a nurse as her and an engineer as him. Google took quick action and said it ended up removing pronouns before launching the feature in May. They realized that they needed to fix Google Translate also, because otherwise it was only describing men as doctors, and they had to change that so that the translation could be either she's a doctor or he is a doctor. Artificial intelligence and machine learning mimic the biases of the human creators. And as many of AI systems look for patterns in huge troves of data, such as what we say to our voice assistants or what images we post on social media, they start imbibing the same gender or racial prejudices that we have and putting it out there. Given that algorithms are rapidly and being deployed by banks, healthcare companies, big businesses, governments, this built-in gender bias is a cause of great concern for our current and future generation. What's more, we are moving all this decision-making responsibility to a system and then trusting that system to be unbiased. But over time, it is hard to predict why a machine has over time. How do we stop that from happening? A male technology industry would also end up creating products that neglect the needs of women as users also. Very often, tech products are born out of personal experience with a problem that the founder is trying to solve. Take Jobs for Her, for example. So the reason, what I was sharing was that the reason why I know all this firsthand is because of the career journey that I myself went through. Yeah. I graduated from the Wharton School of the University of Pennsylvania with degrees in marketing and finance. Right after I graduated, I started my first education startup. It was called Paragon, and I brought the advanced placement program back to India. And I did that in Bombay, which is the city where I was born and brought up. And then marriage got me to shift to Bangalore, because of which I shut down Paragon, and that became my first big career shift that happened in my journey. And I joined my husband's family business, which was in pharmaceutical manufacturing. Now, the shift was very difficult, jumping from finance to education to pharmaceuticals, but it was a great learning process. I loved it. And, you know, I never thought I'd stop working there. That's when motherhood really came into my life. And like I like to say, that a baby gave birth to a mother. And I took a break for 3.5 years in my own career. When I wanted to get back to work after 3.5 years, I realized the challenges that women face when they want to restart their careers. Luckily for me, I had a family business that I could jump into, and which is why I got back to Kemwell. But when I restarted my own career, I realized what a positive experience it was to get back to work. And I started questioning all those around me on why they weren't getting back to work. When I realized how deep-rooted these problems are in India, it prompted me to start Jobs for Her, because it was extremely important that we figure out how we can get women to accelerate their careers. And today, I'd like to talk to you about three different types of women that where it is imperative that we solve the problems that they are facing if we want to increase gender parity in the Indian workforce. First and foremost, let's look at what's happening in the women returnee space. Testament, first generation put in to make that happen. But out of those 40 women, only 8 pursue a career. And out of those 8, 50% drop out in 3 years, which means there are 20 million women in India who want to restart their careers. But the challenges that these women face are manifold, and it requires a management degree of a whole different type. Women returnees are often found figuring out how to manage their guilt of being a bad mother, wife, daughter, how to manage their time between their family requirements and work responsibilities, how to manage the fear that they feel that the world has moved on without them and they won't be able to catch up, and how to manage the plethora of biases around them, starting from home where people question them on why is there a need for you to work, to the office where peers question them that are you really serious about your career? And there are several things that companies can do to fix this. One, removing biases from the minds of recruiters, hiring managers, and also sensitizing colleagues about the loss of confidence that a woman faces when she's on a career break. Two, mentorship and buddy programs that will help in building up the confidence of that woman returning. Three, returnee internship programs, which work very similarly to an internship for a fresh graduate, but at the end of which that woman can be rehired as a lateral joinee. And fourth, reskilling initiatives that will help women in updating their skills and getting back up to speed with the latest technologies and latest trends. Let's move to the second section, which is on women in technology. Today, there are only 26% of women in engineering roles in India. And companies such as Google, Microsoft, Facebook, Twitter, all of which are shaping our current and future lives, they employ less than 20% women. And the reason why it's imperative that we fix the participation levels of women in tech is because all our futures lie in technology. And given that algorithms are rapidly becoming more and more responsible for more and more decisions about our lives, this built-in gender bias is a cause of grave concern for our current and future generations. And for an engineer, for an industry in which there are 3 times more male engineers to females, the biases are going to be large and omnipresent. In fact, the AI industry employs the lowest proportion of women in the tech sector, and there are just not enough female voices which are influencing machine learning and artificial intelligence. So what can companies do? First and foremost, we need to change this bro culture in organizations and realize that what an engineer can look like includes women. Second, we need to change the rules of the game. We need to be more flexible to the needs of women. Expect less than, instead of thinking about 24 hours a day and 7 days a week kind of a work schedule, think about trading in hours of work for quality of work. And we need to create strong skilling, mentorship, and networking programs for women in tech so that they have the tools, support, and inspiration to grow in their careers. And these initiatives benefit not just next generation of young girls that tech is a viable career option for women also. Lastly, women in leadership. And which is why we have built HerTech, which is a platform that is specifically for women in technology, so that they can showcase their skills through challenges, they can learn from industry leaders through masterclasses, they can find the right kind of job opportunities in family-friendly companies, they can connect with other like-minded women in tech and grow their network, all so that women in tech can accelerate their careers. Let's look at what's happening at the women in leadership space. In most companies in India today, entry level, you will find they will have 30% women, but that number will deplete to 10% at the management level and then 1% at the CXO level. And the need for women leaders is obvious. As research shows, companies which have both genders in the executive committees far outperform those companies that have all male committees. At the end of the day, better diversity equals better results. And the COVID pandemic was a great way of realizing how important it is for us to have more women leaders. So I can just pick up from there where, you know, that the reason that we need to have more women leaders in companies has become even more exacerbated by the COVID pandemic. Yeah, if you see the kind of countries that have managed the pandemic very successfully have one thing in common, and that is that they are being led by women. But to get more and more women to lead companies is going to take a whole generation of work, and companies need to work very hard to make that happen. First and foremost, we need to ensure that there is pay parity between what a male employee and a female employee earn. Secondly, we need to have structured leadership development programs for women so that they can overcome the roadblocks that they are facing in their careers. And thirdly, we need to ensure that we are creating the kind of workplace policies, environment, culture, etc., that also enable women to succeed and not just the average employee that currently is a male. Because only if we do all of that can we ensure that tomorrow the kind of women leaders that we see out there are far and plenty and not the exception to the rule. And which is why JobSaha, we have actually started a club called the Her Key Club, where women network, learn together, grow together, and reach to the top of their careers and achieve their full potential. All of this is really to ensure that the next time when we search on Google for a computer engineer, it doesn't show up all male results. It shows up male and female results.